My dear good people of Edo State, I am addressing you today on the unfortunate events relating to the Edo State House of Assembly. The crisis in the Edo State Legislature dates back to June 17, 2019, when upon my proclamation of the 7th Edo State House of Assembly, some members-elect refused to present themselves for inauguration. The Federal High Court, sitting in Port Harcourt, Rivers State, in a judgment delivered on 12th of September 2019, decided that my proclamation of the House of Assembly was lawful and that the National Assembly could not take over the functions of the Edo State House of Assembly as the conditions for doing so did not exist. The court judgment affirmed that the House of Assembly was duly inaugurated and held that the governor or any other person could not issue another proclamation. After this judgment, the 14 members elect continued to stay away from the House of Assembly and refused to be inaugurated to perform their elected roles of representing their constituencies. Having failed to sit for over 180 sitting days, the leadership of the House of Assembly had no option but to declare their seats vacant and requested the Independent National Electoral Commission, INEC, to conduct fresh elections to fill the vacancies that had been created. Following this action by the leadership of the House, the 14 members elect approached the Federal High Court, Abuja, to challenge the constitutionality or otherwise of the declaration of their seats vacant. This suit is still pending in the court. This unfortunate situation has festered because a former governor of the state is bent on throwing Edo State into crisis ahead of the forthcoming governorship elections. I want to salute the resolve of all well-meaning Edo people in standing up to thwart the evil plans of these undemocratic elements who are bent on perpetrating an assault on our democracy by the purported inauguration in a private residence. These events portend great danger to the safety and security of our polity. It had all the hallmarks of an attempted coup d'etat. The people of Edo State rose as one to prevent the desecration of our democracy. It is, however, worrisome that certain persons are willing to plunge the society into avoidable anarchy and conflict just to satisfy their illegitimate objectives. These acts are tantamount to treason, contrary to the provisions of the Nigerian Constitution. Be rest assured, dear people of Edo State, that our government will take necessary steps to defend the rule of law and democratic ideals. Any person or group of persons who set out to test our will in this regard will meet with the full wrath of the law. Once again, I thank all Edo people for their resolve to defend our democracy and honor as a people. Thank you, and may the good Lord continue to bless and keep Edo State and the Federal Republic of Nigeria.